I took all the fuel and water out of Ed's truck.
Good.
Are we going to go in now or wait till it's cooler?
We're going back, Johnny.
Back?
No choice. And when questions are asked about Ed's death, it was an accident. He got lost in that sandstorm.
Look, what's this all about, Ellie?
I'm trying to protect a dead man.
From what? Look, if you want me to lie, I'm entitled to know the reason.
Look, believe me, if we stick to this story, no one gets hurt. Come on, Sam, old fella. Come on. Take it home. Come on.
What about McElroy's monster?
What about it?
Well, I mean, it's got to be close, around here somewhere. We've come this far. A few more hours don't matter.
Forget it.
Well, it could be over the next hill.
It isn't. I said it isn't.
Well, how do you know that? Look, what did Ed say to you before I got here yesterday? He told you, didn't he? You know where it is.
Even if that were true, if we found McElroy's monster, then what? We've got no prospector's license, we can't peg it, we got no poles, a datum post to register a claim.
Then do you plan to come back?
Right now I plan to get the hell out of here. Now don't be a bloody fool. Just trust me.
Looks like I've got to, doesn't it? Same one as yesterday.
Maybe Janet's called up the authorities.
Or else someone's tracking us. Trying to spot that Copper Mountain in the air.
Well, whoever it is, he won't find it. Garrity's Land Rover. Looks abandoned. And they're going back.
What do you make of it?
Could have got fouled up in that reported dust storm last night.
Those rocks don't look like copper. Still, there's only one way to find out. Can you put it down?
Not a chance.
I'll fix it with K-Deck to pay you extra.
Buster will, but never get to spend it.
Making good time. Should reach Lake Disappointment tonight.
What are you going to tell Janet?
Same story we tell the police.
You take a whole lot for granted, don't you? Expecting me to go along with it.
You want to know the truth? Sheriff. There it is.
That wallet belonged to McElroy.
Where did you get it?
Ed Garrity left it for me. He took it from McElroy's body.
You mean he...
That's right. Ed Garrity killed him. That's what I hoped I wouldn't have to tell you.
Gibson.
Who says we're in the Gibson?
Your pilot radioed his flight plan. So we can save time on that one, eh?
No lure against a man looking for his son, is there?
Well, none at all. But if he's with Alec Hamilton, I want to know where they are.
All those years of rumors. That Ed Garrity killed McElroy and buried him at Golden Soak. Wasn't quite true. Killed him out there in the Gibson.
And he got away with it.
Really think so? Had 30 years of guilt and remorse till he couldn't stand it any longer. Then his conscience wasn't enough. There's his wallet.
What was in it?
A few scribbled words of an old Aborigine story about a man and a copper. McElroy wrote it down on this. Never lived to find out if it was true or not.
So Ed went on and found it.
Ed Garrity. Wasn't just grubbing for minerals. He had a dream of rebuilding Jarabinda. He had this in his hand for 30 years and couldn't use it. Because that would have been an admission of murder. Suppose you could call that the... final irony.
Alec, what are you doing?
Safest you don't know what was in it, Johnny.
Later.
I tried to phone you.
Oh, we've been shifting the last of the cattle over to Golden Cirque. Oh, Prophecy. Prophecy, you should see it. It's like a lake, and the grass is actually starting to grow. What is it?
They radioed from Jigalong Mission last night, Alec and Johnny. Should be back later today.
Oh, thank God. And Dad?
No, not here.
Relax, I'll handle this.
Alec, we are going back into the Gibson, aren't we?
As soon as we get this over, raise some money. Sergeant?
Well, we got your radio call from the mission. Janet's been informed.
One hell of a sandstorm. Had no hope.
I'll take your statements later. Look, I'm... sorry, but there's been a warrant issued for you. You're under arrest.
I've been instructed to oppose bail, Your Worship. The basis of this case is that the accused entered the country illegally after attempting to falsify his own death in the United Kingdom in order to avoid fraud charges that were pending against him there.
He claims that he entered the country on his own passport. That is so, isn't it, Mr. Hamilton?
Yes, Your Worship. We are pursuing this matter, Your Worship. I am advised from Perth that the question of extradition to England is also being considered.
7 days, Mr. Duncan, and then you may reapply. Bail is denied. The accused is remanded in custody.
I'm not sure I can afford a lawyer.
Well, I can. Prophecy lent me the money.
Tell her I love her. But let's hold on a lawyer till we really need him.
Could they extradite you?
Probably.
What about the illegal immigration charge?
Well, I can't make that stick. It's a holding tactic, but it keeps me here. About your father.
I know.
I just wanted to say how sorry I was.
I know. Let's just get you out of here, then we can talk about it, okay?
He was one hell of a guy. Just don't let anybody tell you otherwise.
I don't give a fool. It makes no kind of sense.
You better have that.
Chances are he's found McElroy's monster, or at least knows where it is. So why blow the whistle on him now?
I didn't.
I did. I blew the whistle, Mr. Cutt.
Mrs. Hamilton, remind me never to tangle with you. Can I ask why?
The reasons were private and personal.
Let's leave Rosa out of this.
We can't, can we? She put him inside and God knows how long he'll stay there.
That might depend on him.
Meaning?
Could be turned to advantage.
Damned if I see how.
Well, for a start, Mr. Cogburn, you can search that desert. You can start working from the point where Alec and your son turned back. You divide it into sections and keep looking until you find copper. Now, how's that to begin with?
Mrs. Hamilton, I'm sure you know a lot about smart dresses, the best restaurants, and who's up who in the social register, but you know damn all about deserts, especially the Gibson.
All right, Chris, call it.
Your friend treats me like the hired help, Purdy, and I don't go for that very much. A few thousand square miles of desert out there, you go around in a circle, end up dying of thirst or going troppo.
An aerial search.
The odds are 1,000 to 1. Your husband was our chance, and you screwed it up. Well and truly. Thanks for the drink.
Wait a minute, Chris.
For what?
Let's talk about this calmly. For instance, you still haven't given me the location where Galsy died.
So long, Purdy.
Telephone.
Who is it?
A man called Kadek from Perth.
Tell him I'm not here.
Got a visitor.
Alec. Sorry about this.
Who shot me? You or Rosa?
I haven't seen her, so I couldn't tell you. But would I be here if I'd done it?
You might.
I came to try and help.
Don't worry. Mightn't be as bad as all that.
You sound confident.
When I'm in a corner, Ferdy, I fight. Boots and all. I sent cables to my partners in England.
If they want to press fraud charges, some very dirty washing's going to hit the fan.
Explicit cables, I imagine.
Very. Thanks for your concern. Sorry you had a wasted journey.
Alec, it may not be so simple. Any day now, you could be charged with fraud here in Australia. You want the Blackridge mine. The shares have dropped. It seems there's no nickel there after all.
You knew bloody well that ever was. You and Chris Culpin salted that area.
Careful. That slander can't be proved. You signed a report recommending the site.
You bastard. You blackmailed me into that.
I'll deny it.
That'd be perjury.
If necessary. Your word against mine. Who's the jury going to believe? Me? Or a man already behind bars? But it needn't come to that. There's a way out.
How?
The Blackridge shares could be boosted if they come up with a new prospect. That's what half these mining companies work on. Injection of optimism. Give them a prospect, Alec. A headliner.
You got a nerve.
McElroy's monster is all we need. And I'll get a smart lawyer to fix the other charges.
Go to hell.
You could get 3 years. Alec, you can't handle those things this size on your own. It needs a consortium. If you are locked up in here, other people are going to find it. It makes sense to deal with me. Or else the Chris Culpins of this world move in. Think it over. But don't wait too long.
Hey. Hey, I want to talk to you. Thanks, Smithy.
Chris?
Got a little proposition for you.
Yeah, I heard. Count me out, mate.
What's the matter with this town? All I want to do is raise a bit of money.
Some of us have been in your schemes before, Chris.
This one's different.
They all are.
You might be sorry, Smithy.
I'll tell you what, mate. I'll take that risk.
Hello, Johnny.
What do you want?
Heard you were back in town, working for Peterson. Buy you a drink?
No, thanks.
Come on, Johnny, don't be sore. Just because I pegged that claim at Golden Soap.
You're as responsible as anyone for Ed Garrity's death.
Crap.
Is it? That was the end of his hopes. That's what sent him off into the Gibson.
And we both know why he went out there, don't we? He knew where to find that copper. Hold on, Johnny. Doesn't cost anything to be civil. I was in that plane, tracking you.
I thought it was you.
You and Alec turned back, and I reckon I don't know why. You didn't have a prospector's license. I'm right, aren't I? But I reckon you know where the monster is. And Alec's in jail. He's out of the way. So why not you and me, Johnny? Keep it in the family.
Do you think everyone is as corrupt as you are?
Your mate's no great shakes. He turned out to be a prize crook. Look, you bloody fool, it's ours for the taking. We'll never get another chance like it.
You're a lucky man, Mr. Hamilton. There's your passport. It's been checked and appears to be genuine.
Are you finally accepting that I entered the country under my own name?
Immigration seems satisfied. Now, as for the extradition case...
Yes?
The fraud charges over that tin mine. It appears your former partners can't agree among themselves whether to proceed or not.
Well, that's considerate of them.
On the other matter, it's obvious to me you drove your car over that cliff, attempting to fake your own death.
Well, if people rashly assumed that I was dead, I can't prevent that.
You meant them to assume.
I'll tell you what I'll do, Inspector. I'll plead guilty to dangerous driving and failing to report an accident.
Yes, well, the British police seem to have decided it's not worth extradition.
Well, then I'm innocent.
Like Hildy Vincent Hamilton. You're just lucky.
Yes, I suppose I am.
To do a deal.
The situation's different now,
Freddy. Tightly realistic.
I reckon.
Nothing to do with the fact that you've been trying to raise money here in town and there are no takers.
You've been checking up on me?
Common knowledge, Chris.
Like you went to see Alec in jail. He wouldn't play ball.
Touché.
I'm not altogether a mug, Freddy. You should have learned that by now.
Well, I'll take the first 10.
We'll avoid another guy. If anyone comes asking, we've gone to Mount Newman looking for work.
Take care.
I promise.
Alec got away with it.
He told me he would.
Even that Black Rich mine. Suddenly they found nickel. Well, not that I'm complaining about that.
You shouldn't. That parcel of shares I gave you are going to double in price.
I hope you're not asking for them back, Ferdy.
That wouldn't get me far, would it? About Alec. All you can do now is divorce him. I dare say he won't mind.
You have a sneaking admiration for him, don't you?
I could have done a deal with him, but you made that impossible.
You mean you would have blackmailed him, whereas I turned him in? You are a bit of a hypocrite, Ferdy.
You think so?
Oh, that would have amused you a week or two ago.
I find it no longer does.
Well, that's how it goes.
I'm no Boy Scout, but you, Rosa. Chris Galpin was right about you.
Well, we all make mistakes, Ferdy, don't we? Goodbye, and enjoy your dinner.
head for Winnicky Rock. I estimate 20 miles due east.
Well, we should make that by sundown. You want me to take the other one?
No, you lead. I'll follow. Be anyone.
Could be. But I don't think it is. Where do we go from here?
I wrote it all down for you. That's like McElroy did. Here. See what you make of it.
From Winnicky Rock, walk short day into sunrise. Find them Gibber Hill, rocks all colored in a gold.
Think about it. Take it slow. From Winnicky Rock, walk short day into sunrise.
When to sunrise? Well, that's into the east. Well, no, it's a short day, so it could be winter.
I think so.
So it's north of east.
How many miles could we walk in a day out here, winter's day?
Oh, 10 or 12. But this was an aborigine.
That's right.
Maybe 16.
So we start looking 16 miles northeast of here. We'll take a bearing from tomorrow's sunrise.
Find 'em Gibber Hill, rocks all colour of Ngalta. What's Ngalta?
Aborigine for Kurrajong tree. When I found that out, that's when I started to believe in this. I suddenly realised why McElroy was so excited all those years ago. And why Ed believed.
Rocks the colour of the Kurrajong tree? What?
Green. The only green rocks I know are malachite. And that's a carbonate of copper. It's so simple and logical, it's got to be true.
Now,
They're here. Winnicky Rock. Heading east, I'd say. And there's nothing between there and Alice Springs except a few ranges and 500 miles of desert.
Maybe tomorrow or the next day. They can't stay much longer than that.
That plane. You know who it was?
Yeah.
Oh, I keep thinking of those words written on that piece of paper. From Winnicky Rock, walk short day into sunrise. It's kind of poetry, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
And McElroy. Yeah, he must have been greedy and grasping, like my father. And Ed, who just wanted those green rocks to rebuild things. I hope to God we find them for him.
For him?
Well, isn't that why we're here?
Yeah.
We're 16 miles on that bearing.
Well, it's hilly country. Must be almost into the Rawlinson Range.
We'll work north and south. 2 miles out, half a mile ahead. A box search. Keep your set switched on. Huh?
Right.
Backwards and forwards.
They're making a box search, Ferdy.
I know what they're doing.
It means they've got to be close. It's in this area.
How long before we have to turn back?
And with safety, another 10 minutes.
Proceeding southward. 2 miles from center. Where are you?
On the perimeter, turning northward now.
How far did this thickhead walk in a day?
Keep going till we meet. We'll have a break.
You're on.
Approaching center now. Where are you?
Alec, I think I've done the axle.
Hang on, I'll be with you.
Right. That's a spare we're not carrying.
No, take it easy. We'll have a drink and then check it.
I'm beginning to think that bloody thing is a myth after all. And that bastard up there. Like a vulture.
One that can't land.
No. Well, it's broken, I think. I'm sorry, Alan.
Well, it was on the cards. Leave some of the gear here. Mark its position so we can find it again.
Well, we can take a bearing from that hill over there.
That should do as a landmark. Those rocks. Hang on. Look at them. They're green.
Bloody hell. Copper, isn't it?
Copper ore. Not a doubt in the world.
Oh, I don't know whether to laugh or to cry or just sit here and look at it.
I know.
An ugly little lump of a hill in the middle of nowhere. And it's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. Rocks all color of Nagorda.
Maybe. Come on, let's get the gear. We'll map it first and then take the claim.
That's it, I reckon.
I've got a few more pegs to put on the other side of the hill. You start packing up. We'll move before dark.
escape, Kadek.
I think we can do a deal.
No deals.
You stay out of this, Johnny. That's the idea. Be sensible. Nobody gets hurt. We just put our claim in its place. Get me the camera, Alec. On the ground and step back. Leave it, Birdie.
No. No, you bastards. No.
Been waiting. Thought she'd get back yesterday.
Janet, all right?
Stayed with me last night. I'll get her.
Johnny?
Holding him in custody, but Kadex admitted it was an accident. Yeah. She's been here the last couple of days.
I'm sorry for what has happened, Alec.
Where's Kadex?
Back in Perth. I'm afraid he's not my type.
Who is Rosa?
You are, Alec.
I'm sorry. I want a divorce.
Well, we let the lawyers work that out. Now you are a wealthy man.
Hard luck, Rosa. You got it all wrong. I'm broke. I'm a penniless no-hoper.
Oh, don't be silly, Alec. Those mineral companies are going to pay your fortune for that copper.
It's not mine.
Janet's name was on that license. She owns McElroy's Monster.
Alec!